Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. Now, a very common question I get on the channel is how do you achieve that effortless screw shot? I'll get players that are saying that, you know, I'm trying really hard, I'm doing everything right, but I just can't get the cue ball to zip back. So in this video, we're going to look at how I generate some nice screw back there, get the white moving up the table, and I'm going to break it down into some simple steps for you. Okay, so I'm going to break this down into 10 steps, which makes it sound ridiculously complicated just to get a screw shot. But some of them are just things that we should be doing as players anyway. So let's break this part down. So obviously some of these we can tick off very quickly. I can stand behind the shot, I can walk in, and then I can make sure my aiming looks good. And now let's get on to feathers. So we're looking at, this is part four, the feathers. Very, very important. I get people that are deliberately doing a set number of feathers, or they've been told, okay, let's do three feathers every single time. What I like to teach is, why are we doing those feathers? What are they there for? One, they're there to loosen yourself up a little bit, get that nice relaxed feeling when I'm getting ready to play a shot. And another one is for feel. So I'm getting a nice feel of the power that I'm going to use, make sure I'm nice and loose and relaxed, and then I can play the shot. So use those feathers for feel and actually know why you're doing them. I don't like the idea of telling any players to be doing things just for the sake of it. So they're just there doing three feathers just because they're meant to do three feathers. Do those feathers to loosen up and get a feel for the shot. Now, the next thing we're going to do after those feathers, you'll see almost all of the professionals pause at the cue ball. And that's just to signify, okay, everything's locked on now. Once I pause at the cue ball, it feels like, okay, I've aimed the shot, everything's good, and then once I stop at the cue ball, it feels like all my alignment's good, nothing can go wrong, and I'm ready to play my shot. Right, so we've got those points. We're now up to point number six, which is a smooth backswing. Now, this is also very, very important. The reason you're trying to do this is the amateur player, very commonly, what we're doing is we're bringing the cue into position too quickly. So if I just move this to a different angle for a second. So yeah, let's talk about the backswing. What I'm trying to do is not panic. You'll see people that when they're down on the shot, then all of a sudden the cue comes back and then they hit, and all of a sudden they've hit the shot very, very quickly. What we're trying to do is not panic. We want to load the cue into position, or get the cue into position in a smooth and controlled way. The other big common mistake here is that players will speed up towards the end of their backswing, and actually you want to be bringing the cue back, slowing down a touch, and then going. So that backswing is very, very important. We're going to get the cue, do all those other things, get the feathers for feel, nice and relaxed, and then bring the cue into position smoothly, and then we're then ready to play the shot. Now, the next stage is the delivery. Again, on those screw shots, people are panicking. They're trying to hit the ball too quickly. We've got to try and smoothly, with relaxation, no tense muscles, try and smoothly push right the way through the cue ball. So let's try both of those. So the backswing and the delivery. So standing behind the shot, walk into the shot, confirm that I've got everything online. My feathers are for feel, feels good. Nice pause at the white, load my cue into position, and then smoothly push the cue forward. So I smoothly got the cue into going through the cue ball. Okay, now the last part is you've got to really exaggerate pushing the cue through the cue ball. So the way I always explain it to players is that I'm trying to almost feel like when I pull the cue back, I don't speed up at the end of the backswing, I slow down a little bit. Then when I hit the shot, I'm trying to keep the tip in contact with the white as long as possible and push the cue ball along. That's going to get those extra revolutions on the white and get the cue ball spinning backwards. Very, very important. So you've got to try and exaggerate that feeling of pushing all the way through the cue ball. So let's go through all these. So I'm standing behind the shot. Looks good. I walk in. Make sure my aiming is all good. Do my feathers so I'm nice and loose and relaxed. Pause at the cue ball once everything feels like, okay, you absolutely can't miss now, it's all good. Smoothly get the cue into position, don't do it too quickly, and then smoothly build up and exaggerate that push through the cue ball. So you've got to push it forward, exaggerate that push through the cue ball. The last thing I'm doing is then just watching the shot and just get my feedback. What does it look like? So you've got to be really careful here that you're not panicking, you're not trying to hit too quickly. So I go down to the shot, my feather's there just for me to serve a purpose, it feels good. And then I go right the way back, and then I push right the way through, and you can see, yeah, the cue ball has zipped all the way up the table. So let's try that again. So we go there. So obviously a lot of these things now are happening for me naturally. I'm not having to think about all those things on a checklist as I play. I did think about them when I was learning because I just didn't do some of these things naturally. I wanted to bring the cue back too quickly and I would snatch at the shot. So when I was learning these things, yeah, it was very important that I, nice and relaxed. So yeah, make sure it feels good, smoothly back, push right through. So yeah, I'm feeling like I'm really pushing right the way through and you'll really get that zip on the cue ball there. This is a last bonus tip, and this is very common that I see this. People are way too tense generally when they're playing snooker. So you might even see people that hold their breath when they play these shots. So they're getting ready to play a screw shot and then and they're holding their breath and they're all tense and they've got this big tension as they're trying to play it. And you want completely the opposite of that in order to play a good screw shot. So when I actually go down to play this shot, I'll actually breathe half of the air out, nice and relaxed when I'm down on the shot. You don't really want to be breathing in and out. You want to be nice and relaxed, nice and calm. So I'll actually might take a breath and then half of the air out so I can still talk nice and relaxed and then right through. So now I've just put the other camera here on the table so that we can see on the cue ball. If you're still having problems here and you can't screw back, it could be because you're just not quite hitting low enough on the cue ball. Now, when we play a screw shot, we are very low on the cue ball. The top of my tip is the only part that's actually gonna contact the ball. So lots of people will be a bit too high and you just won't generate enough screw by doing that. So if you do that, the white doesn't really come back very far because it's turning, it's making the shot have a bit of a stun effect, so it's turning into a bit more of a stun screw. So when I play this shot, I have got to get very, very low on the cue ball. So if you're trying to do everything right and you feel like you're pushing through and you're doing everything right, you're nice and relaxed, you don't feel tense, you've just got to probably go lower on the cue ball. So I'm going to go where I think is really low here, like that. So nice and low, push through. So that time, I got a much nicer reaction with the cue ball. It really zipped back with not much effort. Now, another thing to talk about here is angle of the cue. So what angle do you want the cue coming down at the cue ball? Do we want it really, really flat, or do we want it coming down at a bit of an angle? Now, when you've got the cue at too much of an angle, I always think you generate a lot of spin that tends to run out quickly. So it's a bit like that effect where you're chopping down on the cue ball and I'm getting the white to spin backwards, but it immediately stops, it runs out quite quickly. So I always think if you can get your cue quite flat to the bed of the table, that's important. So when I'm playing a screw shot, my normal hand position would be here. So I'm lowering my hand, I'm trying to flatten my bridge out so that I can get to the bottom of the ball. And then the back of my body, I don't want it too high. I want to try and keep the back of my body low. If that means for tall players that you put a tiny bit of a bend in one of the legs, that's okay. But yeah, I'm trying to get my cue relatively flat to the bed of the table so that I'm putting all the energy going forward and pushing through this bottom part of the cue ball. So the angle of the cue, that could be something else that's important for you to consider. So I try and get this, my bridge hand flat. Yeah, my cue is nice and flat to the bed, and then I can pull back and go right through. And that time, yeah, got a nice part and a really good deep screw shot there. So the angle of cue, maybe that again is something to consider if you're not getting lots of revolutions on the cue ball. The last very important thing when you're playing these screw shots, it is not about muscle power. So lots of people think that if I can hit it harder, I'll generate more spin, and that's not really the case. That's not what we're doing. It's all about that word that we hear. We always hear it all the time, timing. So what is that? It's just about the smoothness that the player is getting through the ball and they're generating maximum spin for minimal effort. So that's what you're trying to achieve. So again, you'll see players that are, you know, gearing up to play that screw shot and that, you know, they're very tight and tense and hitting it really, really hard. But that's not how you want to be playing a good screw shot. So again, it's all about, as I say, being relaxed. The smoother you can go through the ball, the better. You will actually get better screwback reaction. So I've got to relax, not about maximum power. It's just about the smoothness with which I pull back and right through the ball. And that time it zipped a lot more and it was far less effort. So it's not all about muscle power. So as always, everybody, I really hope you found this video useful. Like, comment, subscribe, all the usual stuff. For anyone that's interested in any personal one-to-one coaching sessions, I'm working on this very table all the time, helping players to improve their game. All my details are in the description box below. So if you have a look there, contact me and I'd love to help you with your game. As always, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. Stay tuned for next week's video. Cheers.